In yesterday's video, I shared with you the words of the CEO of Air Systems and how he explained how he was adapting their product to take care of or to react to the changes that were happening in the silicone wafers as a result of gallium nitride and photronics. And as a result of that, I then said, well, I need to go deeper into what is photronics and how is it going to relate to the semiconductor industry and who are going to be the major players. To understand photronics, I think the easiest way for me to understand it is I used to get my internet on a cable, a hard cable that was laid in the ground, and I thought of it like the same thing as an electric cable. It sent a signal through what I believe was a copper wire. That's since been replaced, and now it comes in a cable that is basically sending a laser light through. It's more efficient, it's faster, and thus decreases latency. Well, that's the same thing that is evolving in the semiconductor industry. Rather than use copper wire to connect the terminals inside a semiconductor, they're going to go to coaxial cable, and they're going to use photronics to send signals inside of semiconductors and inside of servers. So this, and this is because it's more efficient, doesn't generate as much heat, and it's more longer lasting and decreases latency. So with that in mind, I wrote a 5-page article on understanding photronics in the semiconductor industry. And you'll find that on our website, bestofusinvestors.com, and it will give you a link under articles. So go look for that. So the questions I wanted to ask is, what is photronics? And I go into that, and how does photronics used in semiconductors, and why is photronics being used in semiconductors more as a result of the GPUs in the data centers? And then what I wanted to do was say, okay, who are the major players in this, so that we know, once we understand the concept and the need for it, well, who are the major players? And again, I dug in and went into detail on each one of them. The one that stuck out to me is Marvell, and I'll get into that. The second one was that of Intel. Then they listed Cisco and IBM and Broadcom. So then what I did was go through them and give you some explanation as to how each one of these fit into photronics and the future of semiconductors and AI technology. What stuck out to me was Marvell. Marvell is a designer of semiconductors, and they bought a company by the name of Inphi, I-N-P-H-I. And I go into some detail in my blog or my article about why did they do this? Why did they buy it? And what you learn is Marvell wanted a leg up. They wanted to take the benefit that they have learned from Inphi. They had some mutual customers, so there was some strategies there that benefited them. And so what it all comes down to is, in my world, is how are they going to make money? And when I see that, what I look for is what are their projected earnings going to be in the future as a result of this purchase of Inphi. And what you're going to see in the article is I'm going to compare the earnings and revenue growth of each of these companies, and then based on my theory that a stock price is